Oh, this is not good. And ow! Oh! What's up, guys? So this is a re-upload of the same video I posted on Friday. I got up early on this Monday morning to just make some small changes to this video. For those of you guys that haven't seen the full videos that I'm reviewing here, we got some feedback last week. So most of it positive, most of it positive. And even a lot of constructive criticism, I think, from the people that are part of the journey, part of the channel, the subscribers. The video kind of is doing really well. So people from other countries, people that aren't subscribers, followers, are catching this video on their feed and are looking for the full video, but they can't, they need to look at me talking. So, warning, there's going to be a lot of talking in this video. So if you don't like talking, then don't watch the video. Yeah, I've got plenty other content with lots of action, sliding cars, all sorts of cool stuff. This is a reaction video with lots of talking, but you can watch either the entire video, if it's a short one, the reviewed video in here, or the 7-minute video. I've made a highlight clip so you guys can get the vibe. I'm constantly trying to level up. You know, this is a new thing we're learning here, and we're trying to make sure that we're creating the best content for you guys. So I do take on your feedback. And in the vein of this video, because this video talks about combative energy and escalating the combative energy, for those of you guys that are coming in a little bit hot with your comments, I'm just gonna go, it's cool, noted, and make the necessary changes. For those that are subscribed, thanks a lot for subscribing. Please feel free to like the video. And for those that aren't, know that when we do get to 10,000 subscribers, we are going to be doing a GTR R34 fan ride along. Anyways, guys, without further ado, here is the video with those changes. Enjoy. Before we get to the serious stuff, let's have some fun first. And let's do a couple of breakdowns on some things that we can laugh at.
Dude, you just busted your freaking
intercooler?
Radiator.
Can this thing even drive without its radiator?
I don't know.
So this video came to me a while ago. It's been doing around for a couple of months now, but I thought, let me break this down quickly. It's a fun video, and we've all made mistakes like this, so hopefully these guys learned from the mistake too. Here we go. Okay, so far, so good. Donut into donut mode. In his mind, he definitely thinks he's going sideways. For sure thinks he's going sideways. For sure this car is drifting at this moment now. But little does he know, it's understeer city. It's understeer city right there. Now, they are very lucky they didn't hit this thing yet. You know how hard these things are. They don't move when you hit them. That's a very heavy piece of metal there. So if he had to hit that, I think it would have been way, way worse. But I don't know if you guys know what happens next, though. Doof. Yo. 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 Yo.
Dude, you just busted your freaking
intercooler?
Radiator.
Gearbox in its mood.
I don't know.
She asked if you can drive without the radiator. Let's watch again. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness, Shaman. So this is pretty obvious what happened here. I mean, he just didn't understand what the car was doing there. It almost looked staged. I thought this was staged at first because, like, no one drives that badly, but he didn't know what a slide was. He thought the car was sliding. The car definitely wasn't sliding. And let's assess the damage here. That is, looks like part of the engine mounting, I think, or gearbox mounting. That oil over there, that's engine oil. Sump definitely got damaged. Gearbox probably doesn't work anymore. Suspension on the side here, definitely damaged. I mean, this guy's car is badly,
dude,
badly
you just
hurt.
Busted your freaking
intercooler?
Radiator.
This guy's car is badly hurt. Shame, bro. No, this car's not driving anywhere. This car is not driving anywhere. Now, let's look at the next one. Let's take it local. Let's go local.
Mm-hmm.
So, let's go here. This guy's about to catch on nonsense here with his M3 looking good so far. As you can see, he's balancing the brakes and the throttle. The traffic, who cares? This guy's loving it here. He's loving it. He's having the best time. But then... Now, as someone that has done something like this, I'm not going to say when, where, what, how, but I've been busted in a very similar way, I can totally relate. Now, the thing is that this looks like main road retreat. So it's probably not a good idea to be doing this in the main road. That's the bad idea. That's the slice. That is the really the slice. This looks like main road retreat. I'm not sure, but I actually crashed my golf down the road from here long ago, late one night. And you know that chicane there in retreat, that S-bend there? I used to drive fast through there and I lost control of my car and crashed. This guy's lucky to probably just get away with a fine. I don't think they would have arrested his ass or anything. Maybe just a fine. But so far so good. I mean, he clearly has done this before. He knows what he's doing. It's not like he's lame at it. It's just that he did it at the wrong spot. Oh, that's embarrassing though, eh? That's embarrassing. Like, everybody that knows him knows that he got busted like this. But then again, he's got this cool story to tell. Hopefully some lessons have been learned. Shame. Oh, that cop looked keen. I tell you what though, when the police catch you doing stuff like this, they are out for blood, eh? They are out for blood. And that cop jumping in the back seat, he jumped out there pretty fast. This was bad. Same type of car, same color, four door though, so it's not the same guy. I was wondering if it would be the same guy, but it's not the same guy. And then this is interesting. Check what he does, you know. On the power, and then there. Now we can't see what happens in the accident, right? But we can hear the engine cutting out. And what happens is that's the panic situation where you lift off too suddenly. And when you get the car into a slide, you can't just lift off the power. Oh, I would have been saying that. Oh, when you're going through a slide that you can't just jump off the power. He jumped off the power by the sound of things. Just listen up. Off. Poof. Yeah. So he jumped off the power there by the looks of things. And what happens then is that the weight of the car gets shifted forward. And the back of the car gets light. So when you look at the end result of where the car ends up on the pavement here, you can see that he was obviously trying to go through this section over here with this guy standing, right? He was trying to go through that section. But as he came through there, he lifted off. So then what happens is the nose bites, the back gets light. So you get more slide, right? You get more oversteer. But the problem is if the front of the car bites, what happens then is it tends to turn in more tight. So the radius of the corner tightens. So he wants to be one car length over to the left, right? That's where he wants to be. He's now one car length over to the right. If he had to just stay on the power, he might have been able to squeeze through that gap. Now, this is why with drifting, it requires something called commitment. So my sponsor always used to tell me this, like when you drive, you have to commit. You can't be half in and out. That's why I don't like street drifting so much, because street drifting is difficult because you have to fully commit. If you half in, half out, then stuff like this happens. And that's the problem with pavements and things like that. And again, like I've hit pavements at the Gymkhana, I've bumped into a pavement like this. And I want to make sure that all the guys that know whose videos I'm analyzing, that I have made similar mistakes. I have definitely written cars off. I've definitely done stupid things. I'm testing an M3 V8 this week, and I hope no video comes out of me doing anything stupid. But I feel for you guys, I really do. And at least this guy doesn't have that much damage, to be honest. Oh, shame, bro. Shame.
Oi, oi! 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 Oi, oi!
This is the aftermath. The guys are jumping in. The guys are helping out. It's nice to see, putting bricks under the wheels. Come help, bro. What you standing there for? Help the man. No, that's nice. Who's helping? Huh? Everybody makes mistakes. Even Drift King says, even monkeys fall from trees, man. It happens. It happens. Just learn from it. There was a car there on the left, on this side here. So he probably saw the car as he came around the corner. I just made a mistake, man. He was in a parking lot, got a bit crazy. It freaking happens. Now, let's talk about this, shall we?
Jesus Christ!
What's
Latin, bro?
Come now! Who went to that?
There's bongos in a Latin. There's bongo Latin. Yeah, there's bongo. Come, bongo man. I'm bongo man. Come, bongo man.
You will destroy my car when I destroy you. Don't tell me. And not if you're not. You're gonna see me here today. I'm from Cameroon, very good.
I'm just coming around.
Okay, let's see. You touch my car, touch yours. Tell me. I'm gonna beat you guys here one after another.
Don't tell me. Be the bigger person.
If you think you're powerful. No.
No,
you think you guys are
bigger, be the bigger person.
Hey bro, he's push Nurian Naimi bro.
Be the bigger person.
Hey bro, more than Naimi bro, he's massive push.
Now, before I continue to discuss this, know that I'm not going to break this down. Driving stuff. I'm going to talk about something quite specific here. And some people might not agree with me on what I'm saying here. And I think this might be a bit controversial for other people. But I'm just going to give my opinion on one of the factors that I think is important to know about the situation, right? I make car content, but I watch combat content quite a lot. So for me, like, fighting stuff fascinates me. It really, the science of fighting, the psychology of fighting, all that stuff fascinates the shit out of me. So this year is what they call a combative situation, obviously, right? It's road rage. So there's this thing called combative energy, where let's say you got this guy over here, and he was apparently, and this is all hearsay, he was apparently driving behind a Golf that was going slowly. Apparently this Golf is, the guy just got the Golf, he was cruising around. And I still don't know who's 100% at fault here, but everybody is kind of at fault if windows are smashed in on both cars. So the guy in front was driving, and he was driving slowly for the guy at the back. The guy at the back was hooting. That's road rage, okay? He escalated the combative energy to, let's say, a 6. So a 9 would be, we're fighting now, right? So he escalated the energy to a 6. Now, in a situation like that, it's up to the other person, and this I got from the Gracie guys, they talk about this all the time. It's up to the other person to go, okay, I'm either going to escalate this energy or I'm going to take it down a notch. So the best thing to do in a confrontation like this is to go like, whoa, bro, put your hands up and say, hey, everything's cool, bro. I don't want to fight today. It's cool. I got my wife with me. The kids are here. Today's not the day. Let's put some gloves on and sort this out on Monday. But now is not the time. Okay, that's kind of what de-escalating the situation. 92% of us are men here, and most of you guys are gonna go, no, I'm gonna flip it, oh, I'm gonna, oh. I get that's the normal reaction, right? That's the normal reaction. But then what happens is, if you puff your chest up and say, I'm gonna move you, that's taking the energy up to a 7. Now the other guy's got two choices. He can either go, I don't wanna fight you now, or he's gonna take it up to a 8. And that's what happened here. Nobody was willing to back down. So the whole thing just did this, one after the next, after the next, after the next. And then what happens is, you get a situation where, like this over here, where the energy just gets escalated to a point where someone does something physical. So watch what happens here. This guy hits this guy with a number plate, okay? The combative energy has now escalated to the point where there is a fight happening. Whether this guy with the black jeans on the left here, he wants to fight or not, there is now a fight happening. So he has to got two choices. He's either going to go, I don't want to fight anymore, or he's going to do something crazier than that guy did with the number plate. And then this happens. Who wants to die? Who wants to die? So he hits the window. In the full video is in the description below. I've linked it to the channels I posted it. He then continues to hit the window in of the other car, and now this is happening. And the thing is, like, as easy as it sounds to have a fist fight, as easy as it sounds to I'm just gonna move this guy, it doesn't work like that in real life, man. In real life, you go viral, your window is now damaged, you gotta go to the police station. This guy almost hurt your lady with a flippin' jack. It's just like, it's not worth it, man. Like, do you think that these people involved here think that this was a good idea? The things that I used to do when I was younger, I would never do it now. Just like, stupid things. The one time between us, okay? The one time there was a guy tailgating me, and I used to be really good at, like, putting cars really close to other cars. And with my girlfriend in the car, I swerved towards this guy next to me, and at the last second pulled back, and we must have been millimeters apart. Millimeters apart. I swerved like this, looking at this guy while I was doing it. And the look of terror on this guy's face when we didn't hit and almost hit. Now, I wouldn't do that now, because what that doing is that is escalating the combative energy up. If he then decides to do the same back to me, what am I going to do now? I have to do the next best thing, and the next best thing is pull over. And now you've got a situation here. He's got a gun or a knife, and then we all got problems. This situation here is a typical example of where the combative energy has escalated to the point of no return. Nobody can back down you now, because if you back down now, you've already hit the man with the number plate. What are you going to do now? You can't back down now. So, guys, that's my brief opinion on what happened here. A very volatile situation, a very volatile topic right now. Man, it's just one of those things. I don't think there's much else happening other than a road rage incident that's gotten out of control. Luckily, nobody got hurt. Just maybe a fine or a trip to the police station. I hope everybody learned their lesson from this. And the thing that I hope that we all can learn from this is that the best thing to do in a situation like this is just walk away. Walk away before it gets to this point where now we need to now do something and go viral. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching. If you like the content, please feel free to subscribe. And we post a video every week. This is our reaction video. I've got the really sick, two really sick projects. We've got an M3 V8 coming and a Civic Type R that we're busy with now. Those are coming in the coming weeks. And please feel free to check out the other videos. My name is Ernest Page from Performance with Page. I'll see you guys in the next video. Cheers.